Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to Daily News on Breaking News on Prince Miller Entertainment TV. Subscribe to the channel, follow us on all our social media platforms on Instagram, Prince Miller Entertainment, Facebook, our Prince Miller Entertainment, Facebook group, our Prince Miller Entertainment TV. We're also available on Twitter at P Miller ENT. Welcome to another edition of Daily News, Everyday News on Breaking News. Today is the 5th of November 2021. So guys, here's the latest news here. And the MDC Alliance Secretary General Charlton Wende yesterday disclosed that the Nelson Chamisa-led opposition party had resolved to lodge an official complaint with the National Peace and Reconciliation Commission, NPRC, over ZANU-PF-sponsored political violence against the party. This follows claims this week by NPRC Deputy Chairperson Lilian Chikwedere that the commission had not instituted investigations into the violent attacks on Chamisa, as there was no official complaint from the party. Chamisa has been a victim of political violence in Mashonaland and Manicaland provinces, where he has been meeting party supporters. The opposition party also claimed there was an attempt on Chamisa's life in Mutare last month. When they said the opposition party would file a complaint with NPRC to pave a way for its official investigations, we are finalizing the report documenting in detail of what transpired in Manicaland, Mashonaland West and Mashonga provinces with the view of submitting an official complaint to NPRC so that it investigates. All those incidents are not being investigated by police, as no one has phoned or summoned any party official to hear our side of the story, when they said. A fortnight ago, following the Manicaland incident, where a bullet is alleged to have hit Chamisa's car, National Police Spokesperson Assistant Commissioner Ponyati said the MDC Alliance was refusing to cooperate in the investigations. According to Ponyati, the opposition party refused to bring the vehicles involved in the alleged attack for forensic examination. Analysts have warned that Zimbabwe is headed for a violent 2023 poll, citing reports of inter and intra-party violence. In a statement last week, the Crisis Zimbabwe Coalition said police were duty-bound to investigate acts of political violence. ZANU-PF has, however, said the attacks against the opposition were staged, managed. So that's the latest here regarding to those incidents that happened in Mashingo, Manicaland there, and of our political violence. We keep you guys informed. The police were saying, you know, the police were saying, MDC Alliance has not been cooperating. I think there was a story here a few days ago with the police are saying MDC Alliance is not cooperating. Then on the other side, the MDC Alliance is saying the police are not even investigating. So, it's either the police or MDC Alliance is lying, one or other. But anyway, they are saying they are finalizing a report which they're going to be submitting to NPRC, which is the National Peace and Reconciliation Commission. So let's hope we'll see political action regarding to that before my campaigns at Tanga at 2022 and again my elections at 2023. We don't want political violence. I think Tanga started here before so many times, whether it is in ZANU-PF, MDC Alliance, you know, we don't want violence. And violence agaraya isiriyo. We are Zimbabweans before any political party. I think I always say this here, saying that, you know what, I don't recommend violence. I don't support violence. And you know, we are neighbors. You know, we cannot be beating each other up because of political affiliations. Because a normal person will never beat someone else because of a political party, because they don't support a party in Ingrikin or whatsoever. Munuesan Vumu, you support a political party another. And again, Munanem Vumu, you vote a Muno and Gachida. And so this is a right of every Zimbabwean citizen. You know, Saga, Katsave Tiri, and we could have Chigizirana go to vote in Ingrikini, would have abusana emotionally, physically. That's not okay, that's bad. And yeah, so we keep you guys informed pakatika any new information. I'm glad that the MDC Alliance is gathering all the evidence and all the reports regarding to those incidents, because those perpetrators need to be brought to book. They need to be arrested. And again, the police should be independent, whereby they can arrest those people who are instigating violence, because the moment that the police don't do action regarding to those actions, tinongoramba tichingoona same scenarios, because vanenge vachizeleka kuti isusu hatisungwe, isusu the police won't do anything, you know, because a political party cannot have a roadblock muroad, I mean for real, and the police iripo futi papo shawo zvoti zviri kufamba sei, chii chiri kunyatsoitika andika. So the police should be able to you know, save and protect, not just certain individuals or whatsoever, but they need to save and protect every Zimbabwean. Ndobasa ravo iroro, and they need to arrest people who are committing crime, who are instigating violence, who are committing violence. Andika. So this is our daily news, everyday news, breaking news on Prince Millen Entertainment TV. Thank you very much for listening and watching. Remember guys to subscribe, like and share. Follow us everywhere, social media, Instagram, Facebook. Andika, be part of us, be part of our big family. Tukura each and every day. Andika, saka, be part of us. Andika. This is the daily news, everyday news, breaking news on Prince Millen Entertainment TV. Thank you very much for listening and watching and supporting us here. Big up to you. Salute, salute. Bless up.